It steals all of it, too. That's the worst thing. Market. Cool. What could I buy here? Probably more revives. I'm not gonna buy revives. I don't need them. At all. I will buy 10 tonics. That's what I will buy. Let's see. Organize first. And 50 health is actually a pretty shitty amount to heal, in all honesty, but whatever. At least I have him there for basic healing. The Elder's House. Is this the house I think it is? Oh sweet, the Rainbow Shell quest. Cool. Yay. Okay, Toma's being hired to go find shit. That's awesome. He gets to find the Rainbow Shell. That's an optional endgame side quest, for those of you who don't know. So you'll never hear of it again till the end of the game. Except for here. Certainly will. Rainbow Shell's a mythical item, so you're trusting some guy to find an item that no one has found for many hundreds of thousands of years. Okay, the hero has come, but no one has told me who this hero is yet. That's great. Okay, so apparently the Mass Immune is the only sword that can defeat him. And by him, I'm assuming they mean Magus. And only the hero can wield this sword. That's great. Apparently this sword will not be well wielded by anyone who does not decide to be the hero person. That's great. This old guy here. Yes, the king has been injured. Cool. That's locked. Cool. Talk to this guy here. I'm pretty sure if you give this guy the bromide. Yes, it is. Give him the bromide. That's what I thought it was. For a magic tab. That's great. I'm not sure who I'm going to use my magic tabs on yet. Might as well decide now. I have a power tab. I didn't even know I had a power tab. Chrono, Marl, and I'm not going to even bar on Luca. So, whose magic will I use more? Marl, obviously. Power tab. Give it to Chrono. Fuck it. Since chances are Chrono is going to be the one overpowering everything in this game. And Marl is going to be my main spellcaster for the most part in my final party. Even though her individual magic is weak as shit. So, who's this Tala guy? That's great. Cool. That's cool. And sure he is. Sure he is. Well, that's about all we need to know there. Go to this cafe here. This isn't the one that Toma's at. Oh, there's the frog guy. Apparently frog guy lives nearby. Nope. Really? You've told me nothing. Okay, so Tala is apparently the legendary hero. Okay, apparently the cave east of the Denadoro Mountains is where Magus is hiding. Because that's where the monsters come from. That's great logic. Wait, this is... Sweet. More of a reason to overpower Chrono. Might as well. How overpowered is he right now? 27. It's actually kind of shitty. Then again, you look at these two. Look at this. Power 5 and 5. Chrono is 27. Damn straight. That's why I never board game all my characters to 99 power in the DS version. I did it for Chrono, and I did it for, like, Ayla, and I think maybe almost did it for Magus, and that was it. I should not have said that and just spoiled half the game. Well, not really, because actually, I kind of did. Well, fuck. Since this house doesn't exist in the future, might as well steal the shit now. Mid-Ethers. Cool. So, the woods are there, and she's gonna guard them until he returns. That's cool. There's one house here I wanted to check out. Is it this one? Yeah, this is the inn that Toma's at. Let's see. Cool. That's cool. Yeah, that's where Masamune is. I guess we're going to Denadoro Mountains to find it. And of course it's guarded by terrible beasts. Sure. That's useful. And that's where you go to learn how to kill the goblins of Famers. That's cool. And that's an allusion to what we've learnt already from the future. Cool. Ah, that's cool. Frogs in the Southern Woods. Energy whirls dissipate if you use slash attack. Okay. That's actually very useless information until you meet the boss. And I believe it's actually cyclone, not energy. Energy whirls mean cyclone. It's just a mistranslation that they obviously miss when they translated the game. But it's something actually I didn't even know about until I played the DS version. Where I actually decided to talk to people and learn this shit. Treasure? Treasure. Can I escape these? Yes, I can. Look at me. MLG dodging skills. And this is an unavoidable battle, so we will fight it. And I think that was supposed to be the hero. What a great person. Look, it's a goblin, but he doesn't have a hammer. Apparently that means they're pussies. It certainly does. That wasn't even a critical. Either that or Chrono was completely overpowered because of those two power tabs. I seriously doubt that's the case. Apparently this is a terrible place. Oh, he has a hammer. He has a hammer. I think I'll get Marl to attack him. 7. Okay, apparently the hammer does increase defense. So, let's see what happens when he loses said hammer. I probably should just use Flame Toss instead of Fire. Save MP. Well, holy shit, 4 furry critical. That's just rape and murder right there. And this is great music, isn't it? Specchio's little music. And let's just stop it here and keep going. Well, stop the music. Not stop the playthrough. That'd be... Oh, I got my revives back. One of them. And this is random treasure chest number 2 with an ether. Which, speaking of ethers, I'm going to use one on Chrono because I have 23 of them. Holy shit. So, since I actually never use ethers anyway when I play this game, might as well use them now. Cool. I always thought there was a way to get down there. Apparently, there's a rock there. And you can't sneak by this way because someone put a rock there too. And you can't avoid that fight because there's monsters there. As much as I wish you might be able to, you can't. Kill him. Wait for Luca. Flame Toss. The easy way to save MP and kill their hammers. Basically, it's the game's way of rewarding people for thinking before attacking. These things still have like 200 health though. So you still need a good attack from Chrono to kill them. And they're dead, and we're moving on. 500 G's. Cool. That's right, this guy. Easy enough to avoid. As we work our way up here. Cool. And this is an annoying area that I really hate. You will see why very shortly. These things. They are very, very annoying. Just use ice. I don't want to deal with their counterattack bullshit. And dead. Cool. It's actually a little bit easier than when I played this on the DS because I saved all my power tabs like a noob. So, and there's my art revive. We have our revives back. Take this. Gold helm. Guess what Chrono's getting? Gold helm. And these both have iron. Do I have anything better? No. Should I have anything better than the iron suits? No. Probably should sell some of this stuff. Like, thinking about it, probably should. Probably. This could be annoying. Unavoidable? Yes. The second you get up the ladder. Just great. Flame toss. And of course he hits me. Well, about the time to kill this thing. It's called an Ogin for whatever reason. But when it loses its hammer, it's called a Goblin, which is weird. So, whatever. Apparently, it just differentiates between whether or not they have, and this thing's totally gonna be unavoidable. Damn it. Hate unavoidable fights. They suck. They really do. Well, that raped. It's 5:30 already.